used in one form of FIFA 23. I thought that I'd go through the web app setup, open whatever packs that the web app gives us, and just go from there. Maybe discuss our plans that we have for FIFA 23. And yeah, I thought we'd do this. It's been a few days since my last video. Getting ready for a move here, so it's hands on deck, and I'm struggling to find the time currently, but I'll keep putting out the content as much as I possibly can. So let's get into this. Let's get back into this. Choose your starter pack. Select a nation that you want your first foot squad to be built around. The countries you select will put more players from that nationality on your squad. So this is an interesting one. I don't think you get like too many good players in this starter squad. In fact, I think it's pretty much just non-rare players. Just trying to think. Of course, England has a fair few decent players, but I imagine we're just going to get smashed with like League 2, 3, 1 sort of players. So I imagine you're going to. It's between Brazil, France, Germany, and Spain. Let's go with France, you know. France always has some good players, doesn't it? We actually got Giroud there. And who is this? Lise Malou. And Lenormand. Not bad, and of course we have this new... We have this new chemistry system, which I currently know nothing about. We will, of course, have to put a small amount of time into learning that before we start our draft series. So what's it telling us? Swap with a high-rated loan player. Select a player on your squad to replace with a high-rated loan player. So I think we're going to go with a striker here. Who should we pick here? So we've got Martial, who I think is probably the pick. Morata, Andre Silva, Jimenez, and Follin. So I think based on pace and league, it would probably best us to pick Martial. Of course, we don't really know how the new game's going to play. But the thing I know about FIFA, the thing that is a constant, is every single year they say that pace isn't going to be such a big thing. And every single year it turns out that pace, of course, is the main overriding factor. So I think in this case we're going to go with Martial. So here we have to choose a kit. Now, we are called Red's Cozy Game, so it only makes sense to me that we would pick a red kit. So let's go with the Halicia. I'm assuming that's a lower league German team, but I really have absolutely no clue. Could just as easily be a French team. And we need to pick a second kit. Obviously, we can't pick a second red kit. That wouldn't make any sense. And of course, we didn't get offered a second red kit anyway. I think I'm just going to take the Chelsea kit. Chelsea kit looks pretty decent to me. And a badge. You know, it's funny. We did get offered a Düsseldorf kit, didn't we? And it was the other red kit, so maybe we should have taken that. What should we take here? Got the option of Spain, Torino, Orlando Pirates, Bohang Steelers, Inter, Kaiserslautern, New York City, Dusseldorf, and Daegu. I would also like to mention, by the way, that I really need to know how the audio comes across in this video. Recording on my PC, I'm having constant issues with the sound. I've got a really good mic. I spent quite a lot of money on the mic, and it seems that I just can't seem to get a consistently decent sound level, and OBS really isn't very helpful when it comes to that. So after hours and hours of playing with it, I settled on this. Please let me know how the sound is coming across, whether it's decent or not. And if it's not, then I'll go back to the drawing board and work something else out. So these badges, again, I think that we should go with something red. So we have the Dusseldorf, Kaiserslautern, Spain. I would say that the Torino badge is closer to brown than red. I suppose there is some red in the Bohang Steelers. But I think we're going to take Kaiserslautern. So that is our start. So let's hit the start foot button. And our loyalty reward. As a thank you for playing Foot 22 last year, we've added these items to your club. There's a x3 gold players featuring 80 plus rare back. Excellent. So let's assume that's gone to a club. For ambassador loan. Yeah. Let's see what we get offered here. So we get offered Vinicius Jr., Sonny and Davies. I think we'll take Son. That makes sense on every single level. So we got Son there. He can play alongside Martial for it. Three games, can't he? So this is where we're sat. This is the home page on the web app. I'm not 100% certain when the new game comes out, but the plan is to be available on the day of release, the early release. So hopefully that works out. Of course, as I said earlier, there is a plan to move, and we're getting ready for the move. So hopefully that doesn't get in the way of getting the new game's content out, but try and do our best. So this is the new chemistry update. Last month we shared a pitch notes article revealing all the new additions to Ultimate Team in FIFA 23. Today we're giving an update on chemistry redefined, feeling the launch tuning, going into more detail chemistry styles within our new system. With Foot 23, our aim is to increase variety, to increase squad variety, to enable more diverse teams, make squad building easier, and to remove common pain points. Chemistry redefined update. Here's a quick recap of chemistry system. Do we want to read all of this or not? Let's just read this first bit, I think, and then we'll have a quick browse of the rest. Players can earn up to 3 chemistry points by having players of the same nation / region, league and club in your starting 11. Positional links have been completely removed, and your players can now link regardless of the position on the pitch. That's interesting. You could have a forward, for example, linked to your goalkeeper, and you wouldn't lose any chemistry. So that's interesting. That definitely adds a lot potential. When it comes to building a team, you don't have to tailor a certain part of the pitch towards a certain league, for example. That's quite handy. Players have preferred so that's interesting. So, 100 chem squads is not a thing anymore. I wonder how that will affect draft, especially when you're going for the high-rated drafts. I wonder if chemistry will even matter when it comes to high-rated drafts. It has to, I think, doesn't it? Okay, so we've removed the negative impact to attributes caused by low chemistry, so players will always play at least their items attributes. Okay. That's strange. That's kind of strange. She'll get deeper into that. The loyalty system has been removed. Now that is good. No more gaining loyalty for SBCs. Oh gosh, that was horrible. So adding players to your starting 11 of the same nation/region, league and club will earn a chemistry pay. Reaching the thresholds, the cumulative chemistry thresholds at launch will be as follows. So having two players from the same club is one chemistry, four players is two, and seven players, three. Interesting. And it's only slightly less, so the club link is nowhere near as powerful, I don't think, as it was before. Which is interesting. I've said interesting a lot, I'm sorry. I think we'll dive deeper into this. I think the people are kind of here to see the club, the star of the club rather than that, but that's pretty cool. It's nice to get these new changes, you know. Okay, so let's dive into the packs. We've got four packs here. Can you buy packs with FIFA points already? I wonder. That'd be cool. Or would it? I'm not sure. Let's open the boring stadium starter pack to begin with. Got a Red Bull, Leipzig, is that a Tifo for the crown there? Magenta and black, I wish that was red. I have to admit, I really don't bother the stadium stuff. It's never really been. And it's quite interesting because I am the type of person who is really big into I'm really big into like immersion in certain games. I play a lot of open world games. It's by far my favorite genre, and immersion is so important to me. But when it comes to games like this, it just doesn't, like the stadium stuff, it doesn't bother me the least. So I think what we do here is we just quick sell everything for the coins. Coins at this point in the game are so important. And none of that stuff really makes me go, oh, I want that, you know. So let's do that. Let's get into these packs. This is, I think, what everyone's here for. I mean, that's what I'm here for, right? So, let's open the first one. Come on. That's not bad. That's really not bad. I mean, you want the perfect player, right? You want to start with the perfect player. But anything like over 83 is fantastic. So we got Unai Simon, Reynoso, Batshuayi, Hart, Traore, Santa Maria, Amiri, Perry Miller, there's a SBC or two that we want to do. Second pack. Hamsic. Hamsic, I think it is. Dest. Sakagni. Bishlo. Our first Premier League player, and you know what, for 75 that doesn't actually look that bad. For a 75, let me iterate that, I mean for a 75 that doesn't look that bad. I nearly quick sold them all there by accident, just did a web app. And then this final pack, come on, something, what on earth is that? Pepe. Now it would have been amazing if we'd got Neuer today. Not because it's high rated, but because it's Neuer, you know. But this is like a Comnable. This is the new Comnable animation and pack and picture. It's very strange that the Comnable cards, which are in general, are generally pretty terrible. They have like such nice cards. They always have such cool cards. Put so much time and effort into the cards when in reality they're just not used, are they? So let's have a look at the rest of the pack. We get Pepe. Let's be honest, his card's not that bad. Cracknote. Arias, the Comnable player. Vicario. Abdelhamid, Yuri Medeiros, Nita, Lise, Aya, who's actually might be our starting centre back, Berger, and Aktürkoğlu. It's a strange one to say. Okay, so nothing really mind blowing, but you know what? I'm actually not unhappy with that. So is there anything else left for us to do? I don't think there is. Foundations, let's have a look at this. I think that might just exchange a bronze player from your club for a bronze reward pack. Let's do this, shall we? At rarity. Let's just do that. No. Thank you very much. Whoops. I immediately went to the button, assuming that would be the exchange button, but it's not. Let's open our bronze pack. I wonder if the bronze pack method is a thing anymore. Okay, store everything in the club. That looks like everything was untradeable there, which is strange. I swear these are normally, I think they're normally tradable. Okay, next, exchange a squad of two players from the same nation for a bronze pack. Okay, do we have two players from the same nation? Goalkeeper and striker. Let's see. I don't think there's any chemistry, but well, positional chemistry doesn't matter, does it? So, in this case, it really doesn't matter. We just need to find two players from the same nation. I'm gonna go with French when. This one. Oops. There we go. Like that. And double click out. Oh. Minimum squad. Chemistry. There we go. So why don't we have one chemistry? from the same nationality. That's interesting how that doesn't work. Does this have to be a goalkeeper? I guess it does. Okay. Submit. There we go. That gives us a jumbo bronze pack. Welcome to Club Wilson. Anything that strikes me about this pack, really? Perfect, let's store all in the club. Oops. 2, France 2, France 1, Germany. Germany. Maybe we can just do the Germany. Up there. Are they? Okay, I think they're okay. So let's do that. Let's just add them to the work area, I guess. I think we're doing the right thing here. Maybe I should have messed about with it a bit more with us, but let's see. Works. It does not work exactly one lead. Okay, so which did we use here? Okay, so we need another German League 2. 3 Liga, okay. Let's see if we have that. Add player, bronze. League. There we go. I think this is going to be one of those. We don't have the right players just yet, because we need to do more bronze packs and stuff like that. No, do this. Oh, okay. Well, that's not going to happen. But what we do is, once I've done it, I might just come back and this needs two from the same club. Once I've done it in the future, we'll come back and we will open the packs together. But for now, I hope that you enjoyed the episode. I hope that you're looking forward to the FIFA 23 content. I may well probably get back on FIFA 22 and do another draft episode, if time allows me to do so. But for now, when I can, I'm going to focus on FIFA 23 content, because I think that's what people want. You know, we've had a whole year of FIFA 22, and now's the time for FIFA 23. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, please consider leaving a like and a subscription. It really helps me, it helps the channel, it helps us reach more people. And for now, stay cozy, everyone.